So we reached the end of day 1C, and one of the survivors is Patrik Ekwall from Sweden. How are you, Patrik?
I'm fine. I actually feel just like a survivor, to be honest. Like I've been on an empty island for a while, and woke up on the beach like Friday did once, and thought to myself, where am I?
Yeah, excellent. There was 120 players starting the day. When did you start to expect that you would be among the 41 players that would make it to day 2?
I did at the last level, actually, before the last level started. When about 45 minutes left, 50 minutes into it, I didn't get any hands at all, so which was kind of lucky because I didn't get into any mess. So then I thought, well, maybe I could actually make it. I thought in the beginning that it was a certain amount of players that went through, like 35 or something. I didn't know that it was a time limit. So well, I thought, well, fuck them. I might do it.
Excellent. Did you have any exciting hands in the end? I think you picked up some chips in the end, right?
Yeah, I had last level. I played maybe 3 pots and one with what's it called, queens, huh? Queens,
queens,
which I won.
Yeah,
was maybe 7,000-8,000.
Excellent. Do you know exactly how much you have to bring with you for tomorrow's day 2?
Yeah, I do exactly, because I counted it several times. I was so tired. I had counted like 5 or 6 times. Yeah, 17,800, which is not much, but still, I'm through.
All right. Well, we haven't seen you before. Is this something that you want to do again, you think?
Yeah, I'd love to play tournaments once in a while, if possible. Because I think this seems like a great hobby for me. I like it. I watch it very often on TV. I don't play that much. And I like it a lot. It's a good exercise for your brain. It's quite exciting for yourself to get into something that you get your breaking bones, like playing soccer at my age. And also, if you're an amateur and just started, there is still a small chance, which I proved today, that you can make it in one reason or two, in one level or two. If I play, for example, bowling towards against a bowling pro, I wouldn't have a chance.
No.
Or tennis or whatever.
Yeah, of course.
Maybe tennis. Yeah. I'm Swedish. But if I play here, we still have a chance. I think it's like 15-20% luck. So
I also saw you got some private lessons or something like that from Henriksson when you were sitting next to him. How was that?
Great guy, great player, I have to say. And he was so calm, nice to me. And asked him a couple of, you know, since I haven't played that much, I don't really know how to behave on the table. Could you talk to players? Can you ask them things? And I talked to him and asked him things. And even asked him, I had this and this, and I felt, did I do the right thing? And he said, well, you did the right thing. I would have done that myself. So he was great in many things. When we had to split tables, I felt a bit alone.
Yeah, all right. You managed to do it anyway on yourself. Really well done. You're going to be able to sleep now and prepare for tomorrow?
Yeah. I think so. I haven't thought about it. I think I'm sleep no problem. Yeah, but I don't think I'm gonna sleep. No. I'm just gonna have a couple of drinks and celebrate.
Excellent. Well done, and I see you tomorrow.
Thank you very much.